Hey, everybody. Hey. How many girls we got in here tonight? Well, my name's Farris. As you may or may not know, this is part two of a two-part show. I was also in part one. Mostly playing music in that show, I didn't really say much, so now I'm going to say some things, irregardless of whether anyone wants me to or not. So in part one, Will and Kenneth, aka Dance Gang, they came out and they did this amazing show and they left all these old cassette tapes lying around, one of which I stole. And then Neal came out and was talking about lots of things and it was a real big mess of a person really. Then Carmine came out. Neal kept calling Peanut Pod, even though that isn't Carmine's name. But Carmen kept taking Neal's photo and then attacking him on mats and forcing him to eat these little bit of honey candies, which would make him forget everything. And Neal really got into forgetting everything. And by the end, he kills Carmine, eats a bit of honey of his own volition. He's magic and pure and white and clean and has forgotten everything ever. So, where does that leave us? White, magic, pure, clean, and holy, and floating in a big, vast, white expanse of milk, what do you get? See, all I thought was going to happen was, I'm just going to have a good time. I mean, I'd show up, play some music on my guitars and my laptops, and tape players and things, and snuggle with the audience. Instead, there was a whole lot of talk. And people attacking people on mats, and people eating a bit of honey candy. Neal going on and on about wanting big, vast, wide expanses of milk. And then some snakes fell from the ceiling. I don't know, America. I didn't write it. I mean, honestly, what's the point? I mean, I can tell you what the point is. It could all be summed up in this one song by Neal Simone, but I get to that in mind. The point is, we didn't need to get all drunk and bruised up and all serious. We could have just had a good time eating cute snacks like I brought every night. Every night I brought them. I mean, if you wanted to say something, just play this one song and be done with it. No need to waste it. Looking around, candy, snakes, photos like these. I mean, if I could just reset the entire thing and play this one song, start all over, we'd all be better off. Let me just tell you something for real, real quick. You're gonna hear a lot tonight about how you'll always find your way back home. It's all gonna work out, and everyone's gonna be perfectly okay with whatever decision you make, that you can be as many people at once as you want. People will want you to be one thing, and you'll pretend you are. Then you really are pure and did forget, but now you're just two fucked up people instead of one. You should be real. What's that painting say? Believe you deserve everything you dream about. You're gonna hear about that too. Except I don't think I want you guys to believe that, okay? I know the road these people are on, people on the show. I know the road they're on. Well, look. Snowing. Caterpillar in the tree. How you wonder who you'll be. Can't go far, but you can always dream.
Tick-clap, boom, boom, clap. Boom, tick-clap, boom, boom, clap. Boom, clap. boom de clap de clap boom boom clap boom de clap de clap boom boom clap boom de clap de clap boom 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 clap boom de clap de clap boom boom clap boom de clap de clap boom boom clap boom de clap de clap boom boom clap boom de clap boom clap boom de clap de clap boom 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 clap boom de clap de clap boom boom clap boom de clap de clap boom boom clap boom de boom clap boom de clap de clap boom boom clap boom de clap de clap boom boom clap boom de clap de clap boom boom clap.
Hey, how many girls we got in here tonight?
Boom boom clap.
Hey, my name is Hannah and I'm a pure white lily of a good time, so remember that.
Boom de clap de clap boom.
This next song is for
clap de clap boom boom clap.
Can you get that noise? Is it noise in the background?
Boom de clap boom boom clap. Boom boom.
Well anyway, here, we're gonna have a real good time tonight. And how many girls we got here tonight?
Boom de clap de clap.
Thank you.
Hallelujah, always dream. I plan on telling you that every night. You know, those songs aren't ever going to be any good, right? Because they're not about anything.
Well, they ain't ever going to be about anything because I'm pure and simple and I don't have anything inside of me. So there. Well, okay. I mean, I do, but I'm not very happy about it.
Okay.
Wait. Don't go. Hold on. Wait right there.
Please help me.
Dead girl in the middle of the floor. Anybody? We claw, we chain our hearts.
spell, a love no one could deny.
Okay. Sorry. Just now, I was just looking. I was looking at you, and then I suddenly felt like what it's gonna feel like when I'm dying. I mean, I could be dying. You know, I have a heart condition called tachycardia. So. No, it was just that looking at you, it just reminded me of when you were leaving me and then how that's all bound up with how much I care about you and...
You don't even remember who I am.
Yes, I do.
But you feel like dying.
You're Father Montana.
Okay.
And I love you terribly. Look, I just know about dying is all. That's all I'm trying to say. I'm going to give you a leg hug. Anyway, doop to doop.
All so crazy, everybody seems so
my me time, you guys. That's the one time of the day I can just sit in my room and I can just read from the good book and, you know, I don't have to think about, you know, how many people I'm gonna be. Chapter 94. I have seen snowdrops in gardens and on the cart of a peasant woman who was driving to market. I wanted to buy a bouquet from her, but thought it not right for a robust man like me to ask for so tender a thing. They're sweet, these first shy announcers of something beloved by all the world. Everyone loves the thought that it will become spring. It's all a folk play, and the entry costs not a penny. Nature, the sky above us, is conducting no mean politics when it presents beauty to all, without discrimination, and nothing old and defective, but fresh and most tasty. Little snowdrops, of what do you speak? They speak still of winter, but also already of spring. They speak of the past, but also saucily and merrily of the new. They speak of the cold, but also of something warmer. They speak of snow, and at the same time of green, of burgeoning growth. They speak of this and that. Down. Still in the shadows and on the hills lies a fair quantity of snow. But where the sun reaches, it has already melted away. Yet all sorts of hoarfrost may still come this way. April is not to be trusted. But what we wish will nevertheless win out. The warmth will assert itself everywhere. Snowdrops whisper all kinds of things. They bring back to mind Snow White, who in the mountains found a friendly welcome from the dwarves. They remind one of roses because they are different. Everything always reminds one of its opposite. Just wait, the good will come. Goodness is always closer to us than we think. Patience brings roses. This old good saying occurred to me when recently I saw snowdrops.
Hey, Neal. Can I just tell you, you should just play this one song and then just be done with all of this?
What song?
This one here, for real. Then we wouldn't have had to do any of this.
Well, in a minute, Ferris. Hey, Ferris, you want to know something?
Sure.
My mom is dead.
No, she's not.
Oh, yes, she is.
No, she's not.
She died in 2003.
Father Montana is your dad.
Beyond this,
I just, you know, I don't even know what she's about anymore.
What do you mean you created her?
You wanted to be all pure and white and silly, so I made you Hannah so you could be all those things. But you're not just Hannah, you're all this other garbage too, with your pimple on your back and your journals and whatnot. You're trying to be too many things to too many people, including me, and it's annoying. So if you can't just be Hannah all the time, then hey, you know what? I'll make you never be Hannah, and then you can sit in your room with your cherries and your oceans and your snow and all that other bullshit till you want to be grown up enough to be Hannah like I fucking told you to!
You can't take Hannah away from me.
Really? Because that's what I'm doing. Put this light vest on. Your mother is dead, okay? I'm the only one who ever took care of you, doing everything for you. You're not gonna matter much. You're not gonna go anywhere. I'll go to your dreams. I'm gonna take care of you. I'm the only one there for you. Oh.
So what do you want to talk about now?
You? Me? Us?
And I write
write songs about how she's dead, and I keep a locket in my pocket to commemorate her. And in a movie version of my life, I'd like her to be played by Brooke Shields. But let's be honest, you know, she's alive, and she cares about me. Would you quit staring at the pimple on my back? I'm sorry, I skipped breakfast. It's the most important meal of the day. Carry on. I have a Shih Tzu dog named Loco. I have another dog named Juicy. I have 7 dogs and 3 cats and a rabbit. And some of the dogs stay with my mommy in LA, but we also have a house here. What else do you know about? I don't know my times tables. For real, you guys are gonna ask me what 6 times 7 is. I have no idea. So, I don't know if I know, which is another way of saying that I know, what it's like to feel so many feelings about so many different people and then just like, you know, not really have any place to put them. I mean, not the people, the feelings. Because like you can see like transcendent amazings from somebody who makes you a painting that says, believe you deserve everything that you dream about. And you know, and they like, you know, they love you. And maybe they always have loved you. And you know, maybe they always will love you for all you know. And you know, you realize that and it sort of like makes the breath, you know, catch in your throat. But then you move on to other logistics. Because I mean, let's be honest, ladies and gentlemen. I mean, it's mostly logistics that we're going to be dealing with. I mean, you know, then you're just going to find yourself one of these days hanging out on your back porch in Brooklyn. And, you know, if you're ever even so lucky to even have such a thing, probably not because of any labor of your own, but because you were somehow, like, you know, whatever, clever enough to convince somebody to do the actual labor required for you to have a fucking back porch. Or maybe, you know, maybe you move to, like, a mid-size, like a fancy mid-size American city, you know? Like the kind of city that people move to in order to realize certain microbrewery dreams they've always had. And, you know, there's no fucking reason for you to live there. You don't have any motherfucking microbrewery dreams. You were just in an archaeology class one time with this guy who was like, hey, my dad, who is an exterminator, which might interest you because you're currently obsessed with William S. Burroughs to the extent that you and your friend Farris and then another friend took a road trip to Lawrence, Kansas to seek out Sane. And, you know, then that friend you subsequently fell out with on Facebook and one time took a spirituality class in California from a dog. Why don't you know, my dad has the bottom half of a duplex open for $250 a month. You want to move in? Yes. Just say yes and then marvel at being awake at 5 a.m. on your back porch in Brooklyn and smoking cigarettes again and writing things down while you're drunk. Could you, like, for real though, could you, like, quit staring at the fucking pimple on my back? I'm sorry, I'm ranting. I know, but I, you know, sometimes I feel like my fans are the only people that I can talk to. You know, like, okay, but here, hold on just a minute, you guys. So, you know how people always are, like, talking about how, like, processes and, like, journeys and things like that, how they're, like, really important? I don't think they know what that means. Like, I don't think it means what they think it means. Because, like, okay, think about it. Like, processes and stuff, that's like recipes. And, like, do you really want to eat raw eggs and brown sugar and fucking unbleached flour, or do you want some motherfucking cookies? You know? Just like some motherfucking, like, you know, just like discrete moments where you just feel like one single thing, like one solitary phrase is worth a thing, or like one song's worth of a thing. And then, you know, you like make playlists and you add things to things while you're thinking of things and put other things in there. And then after a while, it starts to feel like you're listening to somebody. And of course, you know, they're not listening to you. I mean, not the same way or, you know, whatever, you know what I mean. But still, like you walk around and you listen to the things, you listen to them. Sometimes I feel like I should cry on stage, but I never do because I never do.
Like, this is the only room, this is the only room where I'm alone anymore. Like, where I just feel lots of feelings. Like, lots of feelings. And then, you know, you wake up at 4 a.m., something wakes you up before your me time. You wake up at 4 a.m., you start reading the good book. And then, you know, I mean, maybe that's not everything, and of course it's not, I'm just being fucking ridiculous, but you know what I mean. At the end of the day, like, you're just gonna always end up in this room. And, yeah, I think that's the way it's always gonna be. Sometimes I do wish that I could be Hannah all the time.
Hey, why don't you play a song, Hannah?
Okay.
I'm sorry, guys. Listen, I know you guys came here tonight to hear Hannah, but I can't do this. I'm not actually blonde, and I don't have blonde hair and chew gum and act silly. I actually have brown hair, and I'm all, like, busted up inside. Hey, it's me, Neal. The last time I stood on this stage, you know, I was just Neal. Listen, I know that you guys came here to hear Hannah, but I know that I've hurt a lot of people, and I didn't mean to, and so if it's okay with you, I'm gonna I have this song that I wrote, and it's about I'm gonna sing it for you now. It's about what I've learned over the last couple of weeks. I can almost see that dream I'm dreaming, but there's a voice inside my head saying, you'll never reach it. Every step I'm taking, every move I make feels lost with no direction. My faith is shaken, but I'm gonna stay strong. Just keep pushing on. There's always gonna be another mountain. I'm always gonna wanna make it move. It's always gonna be an uphill battle, and sometimes you're gonna have to lose. It ain't about how fast I get there. It ain't about what's waiting on the other side.
Sunday.